That's certainly interesting. Whining dogs. Okay. Well, crossing the hall. Come on. There we go. Look, my vision is like mostly recovered. Still a dot 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 on the sanity though. What the heck happened to this room? Oh well. Doesn't matter that much. Oh, is this oil? Okay. Oil. I know. This thing. Looks like some sort of monk. Come on. Oh, wrong button. Come on. Fine. The room of dog torture. Flashback.
Let's see what you have to offer. Sense it. It's definitely there.
This looks like it would have made a nice pet. Okay, that's creepy. Head. Huh. In the box. Nothing. That's creepy. It is. Huh. Has a date I'd expect it to have read itself. Oh well. 1658, January 9th. Further disappointment. The antiquarian's latest findings yielded nothing. I'm still unable to grasp the inner workings of life and its relation to the subject, to the power I sense within it. I shall pursue more books on the subject, but I suspect it will be in vain. Since no research has been made in my particular interest, I must attempt to fill that void myself. Clearly humans emanate more of the energy I seek, but I hope animals will suffice as they prove less of a hassle to acquire.
Great. What?
Canine spine. And the whinings of the dogs continue. Felt like it was drifting to the side. restored. Hammer. Ooh, look. I managed to increase my sanity. Ooh. And there's a tick box here, too. Just look at what the shadow has done. And in we go. Why are there half pigs hanging here? Have I not shown restraint? My patience spans centuries. From where I came, mankind has not even wasted a breath. Yet I bow to you. I have done so much for you and have gained nothing in return. Agrippa, I trusted you. It was I who, in all fairness, should have entered that gate. What gate? Last rod. Flow cycle rod. Elevator machine instructions. If the elevator breaks down again, make sure to use the steam engine to build up pressure before channeling it into the machinery. Adjust the levers to get the right amount of pressure inside the chamber. The meter should read up 8 and down 8. Make sure the flow is set according to the following chart. Trinity steam set functions, 4-phase amplitude, complete steam flow cycle. Note that the machine will not check proper configuration until all rods are inserted. Okay. What? Didn't I have, like, 30 earlier? And now I have 53? Oh my gosh. I'm sorry, but that's just ridiculous. And now I have 55. That's a lot of tinder boxes. Well, at least my sanity hasn't gotten any worse. And down goes another tree. That's one way to make sure you don't go in the wrong direction. Returning to the main hall. Or back hall, I guess. Guest room. Don't remember what it is that I need from here, but I know where it is and how to get it. I think it's a key.
My journal is gone. What would they want with my journal?
Run, Buggy, run! That's paper. That's not gonna do crap to that bug. Ooh, oil.
July 1839. I received a letter today from the Algerian government office disclosing the fate of Herbert's expedition. About a week after my departure, Abdullah, one of the men traveling with us, returned from the desert. He was badly injured, as if maimed by a lion. The man rambled deliriously about the expedition being attacked by something horrible. The French quickly dispatched a search party to look for the expedition. After searching for days, they found the camp abandoned without any trace of Herbert or his men. Tomorrow, I'll retrieve the things they recovered from Herbert's tent at the customs house. I don't know what to make of it, but I'm worried for him.
Okay. Guess the shadow got to them too. Or at least tried to, because see, there was no sign. Crowbar.
July 3rd, 1839. Today I picked up Herbert's things at the customs house. I dug through the trove of documents he had carried and found a log detailing the expedition. The nature of this text ranged from quick notes to colorful accounts of transpired events. I skimmed the pages, trying to figure out what might have happened. May 17th, the day I was trapped inside the orb chamber, Herbert dryly states, "Recovered Daniel after 1 hour of entrapment." This confused me greatly. I was suffocating within minutes. How could I have lasted an hour? I continued reading the peculiar text. Herbert states his facts without judgment or passion, but suddenly I could read frustration into his text. He pushed his men to investigate the underground tomb, an effort which seems to have strained the minds of his men. Madness spread through the ranks, and Herbert had to take some extreme measures to continue. He finally visits the chamber himself, where he retrieves the orb to the surface. His account confuses me greatly. If he has the orb, what are those pieces in my drawing room?
Dun dun dun. Shirts. Oh, tinder box. And that annoying little cockroach. Door stuck due to a broken lock.
July 1839. It's done. The orb is assembled. I was awakened by an exhausting nightmare. Shaking and sweating, I retired to the drawing room with a cup of tea. The relic pieces lay spread across the table as I'd left them, but somehow I knew how it was supposed to be. I fetched the tar, which I had prepared to fix the pieces together, and without fault, I joined them, producing the orb I remembered so clearly. The tar proved unnecessary. It was pushed out from the joining pieces as they merged on their own, with no adhesive. The ancient stone relic now rests on my table. Its immaculate surface and perfect shape could have been molded by a factory. This is all too strange.